Well, it's Monday, you just can't avoid it. God's got you down, you're feeling exploited. There's only one place that you want to be. That's Martini Monday with Jory Lee.
Sup, fools? Jory Lee here, Martini Monday. Hope you're all doing well and had a great weekend and a wonderful St. Patrick's Day. Also St. Gertrude's Day, patron saint of cats. So naturally we celebrated by changing litter boxes. I hope you all did as well. Not really, that's all. I don't wish that horrible task on anyone, but if you got cats, change the litter box. Just go ahead and change them. It's a good idea. But it's Monday, y'all, and it's springtime, and not quite yet. It's not officially spring yet, but we are in a weird time where 2 days ago it was 70, and today it's 50, and it's going to be 30 tonight. It's insanity. That's why we're all sick. I hope you're all celebrating tonight with a lovely beverage. I, of course, am having a martini. Your results may vary, but I'm going to enjoy a little martini. I'll tell you something silly I did. When I was preparing for this, I actually had a glass of beer that I was drinking. And I was getting the ingredients, and I put the gin in the shaker, and I put the vermouth in the shaker, and then I had my olive brine, and I poured it in my beer. So, down the old hatch the beer had to go, because if you taste that, you're going to vomit. It's olive brine plus beer, not a great combo for anybody to enjoy. Let's get things started off with a little music. This is the first track off of our, well, the second track, actually, off our record, One for the Road. This is the Martini Shaker Boogie. Shaker Boogie, track number 2 off of One for the Road, our release that we put out in COVID time. So, hope y'all all picked up on that. As usual, Facebook, I can see your chats here. If you want to hear something, let the old boy know. Let me go turn this amp down just a hair, a little loud. A little spicy on the amp. I changed amps, so I never can tell. I'm sitting here by myself. It sounds perfectly all right. If y'all want to hear something, put it on there. I tell you something I thought about earlier today, and I don't know if y'all have noticed this, or if it's something that's even a part culturally of your existence, but it's part of my culture and heritage. When I was a kid, it seemed like all of the older ladies, all of your aunts and whatnot, used terms like hun and shug a lot. Like, hey hun, hey shug. And you don't hear, like I'm 50, and you don't hear women my age now call anybody hun or shug anymore. And it got me to, I don't know, I went down this long philosophical rabbit hole. At what age would one start calling people hun and shug? And why did that fall out of favor? And it got me to thinking about older terms that people used to use. Like when we were kids, we watched the old Bugs Bunny cartoons from the 30s and 40s. And, you know, people calling you a mug. When did we stop calling people mugs? That's great. That's a great word. It's funny how etymology, how words come in and out of our language, and then I don't know. I just thought about hun and shug the other day. You never hear anybody call that. I wonder if, like, when my generation, or God forbid, these young millennials get older and they start killing people. I don't know what the kids call each other these days. I'm ignorant. I'm ignorant of the modern vernacular. An old guy. I'm officially that guy. But we all are. You know, I'm the dude when somebody turns around in my driveway, I'm like, not in my holler. My wife says I need to play stuff you can hear at a Martini Shaker show, but I draw a blank. That's why I ask y'all for requests on here, because maybe you'll ask for something I forget to play, or I don't know, or I'll make it up as I go. I was gonna do some loop pedal trickery tonight, but I didn't get myself motivated in time to get the loop pedal going, so we're just gonna play it straight tonight. Still online or not? Tired of all these problems. Tell you all that much. Y'all can see me. Say hello. I don't know. Very odd to me. Let's stand up and see if we're still online. Yeah, we're still there. We're still there. I'm thinking a lot of these problems might be iPad related. I don't care for Apple products. I'll just say that quite matter-of-factly. I know those of you who are big devotees of the products put out by Apple, you know, people who are Apple people are adamant Apple people, but like it's my experience that everything Android is just better. It just works better, no problem. What's up, Jody Jones? Hey, Melissa, how y'all doing up there? Up in Maryland. Like I said, if y'all got a request, y'all let an old boy know. I hope everybody drank a bunch of these yesterday, because it was St. Patrick's Day, and you gotta, like they say, everybody's a little bit Irish on St. Patrick's Day. I love any kind of drinking holiday. I don't care if it's, you know, St. Patrick's Day, or Oktoberfest, or Cinco de Mayo. If Ramadan involves some sort of alcohol, I'd probably have a Ramadan party every year. But I like festive celebrations where people get together and they're in a good mood and they're eating good food. And, well, there's something there. Good mood, good food, good beverages. But I hope you all enjoyed some of these yesterday. And I hope you were reverent about it. You know, a lot of times we have these celebrations and people want to get all raucous. I didn't hear any horrible stories this week of any shenanigans going on here in Birmingham. That's funny you say that, Jody Jones, because tomorrow the wife is off, and tomorrow we will be fixing. As a matter of fact, I'm going to start boiling them tonight. I'm going to do a dozen Scotch eggs tonight or tomorrow. So if you're out and about over in the Alley Bastard area, come on over here and get you a Scotch egg. That racket you're hearing up there, my neighbors threw away a whole bunch of stuff. They were doing spring cleaning out their garage, and there was like a washer and a dryer and all kind of bicycles and razor scooters. You have no idea how much self-control it took for this hoarder to not have every bit of that stuff in my garage, because I wanted all of it, but
I showed restraint. So we got these scrappers that drive around. So if you hear a bunch of scraping and racket, that's them out there. I'm going to do this song. I think I did it last week, but we'll do it again just because I kind of figured it out a little bit. I've been playing the song for a lot of years and been playing it wrong, but I'll play it for you now. See you on here. That time change has got you getting home early. Getting a whole full 8 hours of sleep every night. Yeah, it's getting that time of year where it's daylight later in the day, but it's weird for me like to get up at or to wake up at 6 and it's still pitch black outside. It's like, God dog. You know, usually even in the February, it's a little bit daylight at 6 a.m., but...
Every time.
Young to Boom. Summertime Blues, as he called out today. Called out well, he says. So, guy, boss, I can't make it in today. I'm sick. Yeah, what's wrong with you? I'm sick of working here. Everybody got to do it once in a while. Take you a mental health day and take off and enjoy yourself. Because it's too pretty outside. It's too pretty outside to be slaving and laboring. Of course, I used to have an old guy I worked with. He said, we could have a job where all we did was talk on the phone all day to our friends and we bitched because we couldn't talk to our family. And that's right. Work sucks. It's dumb. You're trading hours of your life for currency. And then they think that they can tell you what you can do on your off days. Good luck with that, pal. I spent 26 years working for people like that And didn't know about the fact that I exist to do something other than what they want me to do. Today I passed you on the street, and my heart fell at your feet. I can't help it if I'm still in love. Once in a while we do. Alcohol may have been involved. Authorities say. Sip time. It's sip time for me. It's sip time for you. Everybody enjoy a lovely beverage. Mm-hmm.
every time I feel the pain.
Songs are dedicated to Jody Jones, who loves him some Dwight Yoakam. I love me some Dwight Yoakam. I can't imagine anybody not enjoying Dwight Yoakam's music. It's just really, really good stuff. Hey Mom, late again. Again, all these shows are always available here on Facebook, on Instagram, and then I didn't bother with last week's show because last week's show was a disaster. I had nothing but technical issues, but I think I got all that worked out now. I got a different method of doing things, and it's working out a little bit better, and I'm a little more prepared, I suppose, this week. But you can always tune in here on Instagram, and then later you can see them on our YouTube channel. If you're not already subscribed to our YouTube channel, absolutely go over there and subscribe. Like it and give us a bunch of thumbs up, and I don't know what the algorithm is, but the more you like things both on Facebook, on Instagram, and on YouTube, the algorithm picks it up, and then, you know, we're trying to grow this thing organically, and that's the way to do it. I'm never going to pay for friends. I'm never going to pay for likes. So if you enjoy what you hear, give us a thumbs up, give us a like, a subscribe, and tell your friends and warn your family, and get them on over to the page, and hopefully we'll grow it. If you like what you're hearing too, the virtual tip bucket is always open. It's Venmo at Martini Shakers. You can throw a buck or two in there, or a quarter, or whatever you feel so inclined to do. All the other, Venmos and Cash Apps and all that, it's always available. Here's one from Tennessee Ernie Ford. Thank you.
baby.
Tennessee Ernie Ford, but we'll beat your best deal regardless. Those of us of a certain age get that joke. I tell it sometimes and it goes over and sometimes it don't. But those of us who remember Jim Skinner Ford, remember the Daddy and Jimmy commercial. So, we used to have some wonderful local advertising here. Like Mr. King. We talk about this one a lot too. You gotta do it this way. I know a lot of my friends that I grew up with remember this, the Mr. King furniture. Where can you go if you need some credit? Mr. King, yes. No darn store will let you get it. Mr. King, yes. With a yes, yes here and a yes, yes there. Here a yes, there is Gary, yes, yes there. Where can you go if you need some credit? Mr. King, yes. Boo! Oh, yeah, we just had some great local advertising. Came out, everybody said, oh, he's just trying to be Elvis, you know, and Elvis talks about this a little bit too, where when he met Gene Vincent, Gene, the first thing he says, man, I wasn't trying to imitate you. And Elvis said, I know, man, you're just doing your thing. But yeah, if you think about it, it does sound a lot like the King. Sip time. Hope you're all enjoying a lovely beverage tonight. We do this every Monday night, 6 p.m. And I hope you can tune in. And Monday night, I figured, the reason I started doing Martini Monday was because Mondays, Garfield taught us this, that Mondays suck. And nobody wants to be back at work, especially after a Sunday, St. Patrick's Day, where some of you, I'm sure, went into work today a little hungover. But I figured let's do a beverage and let's have some music and some fellowship. So y'all tune in every Monday night. I've been kind of toying with whether I want to keep doing it or not, but why not? What the heck else are we doing on Monday night? So y'all keep tuning in. If you're looking to get out this weekend, the only show I have this weekend, I'm solo at Margarita Grill Saturday night, 6 p.m. to 10 p.m. So if you're in the Pelham area or plan to travel that way, come on through and we'll have a margarita and we'll eat some chips, that sort of thing. Let's do a Buddy Holly song. Just you know why. Why that song's written in B flat, and it didn't occur to me until I started writing songs of my own that song was in B flat, the same as so many other songs of the era are in B flat because it matches the natural key of the saxophone. Such things. You always wonder why jazz are always in flat keys, because the tenor sax is in E flat or B flat, the alto sax is in E flat. So many of those songs are written to accommodate the horns because it's just easier for them. And like my buddy Joe Breckenridge says, you know, I'm like, play it in B-flat. You know, it's he goes, I don't have frets on the bass, so I can play it wherever. You do have frets on the guitar, and it's a little more difficult, but doable. But that's why. The request line is open, y'all. If y'all want to hear something, let me know. Boot salad, yummy, yummy. I am wearing a Wiggles shirt, which I think is awesome. Apparently, there's no original Wiggles still in the band except Anthony. I did hear where the Wiggles are going to be on tour this year, and it's like not a kid. It's not like back in when my son was a baby and we were into the Wiggles then, it was like they would have the Wiggles and they had Disney on Ice and all that stuff, but it would be like a kid-oriented thing. But the Wiggles are going on tour, I'm sure, for guys my age who raised kids in the late 90s, early aughts, and they're like, hell yeah, I'll go see the Wiggles. So if they come anywhere near here, let's all get a caravan up and go see the Wiggles, shall we? Let's do, I worked on this a little bit earlier today. Not a song I would have ever thought of doing this away. Uh-oh. What the heck did I do with my slide? Let's do it this way. We can do this the hard way, or actually, I guess, the significantly easier way. I don't know what I did with my harmonica box. Oh, there it goes. There it go. This is the only bottleneck slide that I've kept for any length of time for some jerry-lee. I'll do a little jerry-lee for here in a little bit. I was doing more Carl Lee Perkins, but that's an old blues tune right there, that Matchbox. Somebody asked me, what does that mean, where the Matchbox hold my clothes? Means you ain't got nothing. Everything I own fit in this Matchbox last year. Let's do a little Jerry Lee Lewis for Melissa out there in Maryland. Hey, they up. Chris, I got this old beat up piano over here in the corner, and every so often I will break it out and play a little bit of Jerry Lee Lewis, because that's an out of tune piano right there. But, yeah, every so often I'll play a little bit of Jerry Lewis. I got my, my synthesizer over here. I've been threatening to bring it out, but every time I say I'm going to do it, I piddle around with it and realize that I can't play piano very well. Especially when I've had a martini or two. Thank you. on Chicago. Nobody knows who the hell wrote that one, but the first version I ever heard of it, of course, was on Saturday Night Live with the Blues Brothers. But then I heard Robert Johnson doing it, and I was sold on that song there. Let's do a gospel tune. We can't get away from here without doing at least one gospel tune. Precious Lord, take my hand, your hold let me stand. I'm tired, I'm weak and worn. Through the storm, through the night, your hold of the light, take my hand, precious Lord, lead me home. When my way grows weary, precious Lord, take my hand. That's a good one. I sang that one at my grandmother's funeral. And that's a good tune there. We're going to do about one more here, and then we're going to get off here and let y'all get back to your Monday night dinner. I'm sure everybody's got some fried chicken and biscuits cooking in there. And you want to get on back to it, I understand. Let's see, somebody give me a good one and then we'll get on out of here. Gosh almighty. Do I want to do Hank Williams? Do I want to do a little Elvis? Do I want to do, let's do this one. This is a song by, let's see who did this one. I think Brownie Lewis did this one. All the hills far away, to the old rock and cross, symbol of beauty and shame. I'll get that one. I tell you what, well, listen, next week I'll have that one for you. I have an old rugged cross, that one, and there's another one I'd like to do. So next week maybe we'll focus a little bit more since we're coming up on Easter. In just a couple weeks here, we'll do an all gospel show or a mostly gospel show. Sometime soon. Remember, April 1st, I'm going to be up at my buddy Kendall's place up there, Road Rage Fabrications, and we're going to do a live from up there, so y'all tune in for that. So if you got a cool place somewhere within, you know, an hour or so of Birmingham, and you want me to come up there and do a live from your place, help advertise you, help advertise me, everybody have a good old time. Let me know and we'll come do it. If anybody wants to sit in musician wise, you want to sit in and come play with me, I got room here. I vacuum the rug and everything. So y'all can come on and see me there. Let's do one more tune and then we'll get on out of here. Let's see. I'll switch out for this one. I think I did this one a couple weeks ago, but it bears repeating because it's a good tune. One of my favorite Dwight Yoakam songs. That's Seven Bells right there, baby. Wrong heart. How do they get mixed up? That's funny. This is one of my favorite Dwight Yoakam tunes.
Listen, I was strong. Maybe you
Y'all remember, tune in next Monday, 6 p.m. right here on the same bat time, same bat channel. And we're going to do it again. If y'all want to hear something specific, for instance, Melissa asked for Old Rugged Cross. I'll get that one on next week, promise you. And if there's something you want to hear, send me a message either here, Facebook, Instagram, or, you know, again, go like, subscribe on YouTube. If you want to toss a little money in the old virtual tip bucket, it's at Martini Shakers on Venmo. Same kind of thing on PayPal and Cash App and all that. Some variation of Martini Shakers. Just look it up. My name is Jory Lee Heindel, and I'm sure that name is attached to it somewhere on there. But thank y'all for tuning in. Hope you all had a great time. We will see you next week. Here and again on Instagram and on YouTube. And if I don't see y'all in the future, I'll see you in the pasture. Thanks again for tuning in. See you next week. Bye. Well, doggone.